Good evening, dear Musica Mundi family, dear public. Our artistic director and co-founder, Leonid Kerbel, all our artists in residence, faculty members, young faculty members, staff members, and young talents are delighted to share with you this special evening, the second live streaming concert of this Musica Mundi Special Edition 2021. I would like to thank the TV channel TVCom and Mr. Max Zimmermann for their precious and important collaboration that permitted the realization of tonight's event. Before introducing tonight's concert, Leonid, myself, and the whole Musica Mundi family would like to express again our condolences and support to the victims of the terrible floods that occurred in our country last week and that were repeated last night. During these last days, our 49 young talents were guided by our artists and pedagogues to prepare their chamber music ensembles and solo repertoire. Yes, for already the second time in a Musica Mundi edition, and due to the fairly limited number of students we could accept to this special edition, solo pieces were added to the course agenda. Tonight, you will, therefore, witness the results of both these complementary programs, chamber music ensembles and solo performances, side by side. Ensemble lessons, individual lessons, rehearsals, class concerts, master classes, individual practice, all the above composes the full days of our young musicians. But this summer, we offer even more. Except from the course this year, and not like last year, we could maintain part of our international festival and welcome here some of the world's leading artists. Augustin Hadelich, who enchanted us with a superb performance last Monday, and still coming, Alexei Volodin, tomorrow evening, and naturally, the great violinist and musician, the Musica Mundi School's ambassador, Maxim Vengerov, who will perform on July 28th. Listening to these great performers from close inspires even more our young musicians. We would like to thank all the artists that surround our students during this special edition. Our artists in residence, Jacques Rouvier, Andreas Fröhlich, Jérôme Pernod, Alexandra Soum, Sivan Magen, Sharon Kam, Alexander Khamushin, Julia Dinerstein, our faculty members, Jan van der Weyen and Irene Kogan, and our young faculty members, Mikhail Radunsky, Alexandra Ivanova, and Emil Dams. Leonid, myself, and all our young talents would like as well to thank our sponsors, foundations, and private patrons without whom this edition could not be realized. Martin's Hotels and Mr. John Martin, Bank Delen, Jebel, the National Lottery, La Province du Brabant Wallon, Fay Foundation, Robus Foundation, Total Foundation, ICC, Axis Park Fund, the Alphadin Foundation, Nikedo Foundation, MINV, Chemitex, Pianos Mane, Axis Park, Fonds Bayer Latour, Anad Foundation, Jean Prat Foundation, Celio, Eastbridge, Guest, Rideau Service, Rotary Atomium, EJC, and Alvo. Without the help, support, presence, and continuous encouragement and engagement from your part, we would not have been able to go forward with this special program and make it happen. You were all there for this exceptional youth every step of the way. Thank you. Thank you. Before presenting the first performance tonight, due to the authorities' instructions, we do ask you to keep your masks on throughout the concert. And naturally, please do not forget to switch off your mobile phones. After the concert, a reception will take place in the Ivry Gitlis patio of the Musica Mundi School. And now, time for music. The whole harp class is the first performers tonight. Sivan Magen, our artist in residence and the harp professor in the Musica Mundi School, will be joined by Benjamin from the United States, by 15 years of age Bujana from Albania, and by 16 years old Luna from Belgium. All together, they will perform the Milonga del Angel of Piazzolla. Let us welcome these harp players to the stage.
Thank you.
Abrams was extremely young and passionate when he composed his piano sonata, Opus 2. To perform the finale of this piece, I have the pleasure of calling to the stage 16-year-old Belgian pianist Steven. Steven, the stage is yours. It is not by coincidence that the next piece after the Brahms Sonata will be that of Clara Schumann. This phenomenal woman musician, wife of Robert Schumann, was as well a superb pianist and composer. To perform the Andante of her piano trio, I have the pleasure of inviting to the stage students from our younger generation. Ori is 10 and is an Israeli pianist. Marielle is 14 and is a Mexican violinist, while Iris is 11 and is a French cellist. Let us all give some warm applause to these three very young musicians. Tonight's program is a kind of a discovery program. Instead of placing only the mainstream or the most popular pieces, such as the Brahms, Dvořák, Schumann, or Shostakovich quintet, we would like to introduce to you tonight a new palette of colors. You will hear tonight quintets by Korngold, Goldmark, Dundee, and other great composers, and discover the beauty of their music. Erich Wolfgang Korngold was an Austrian composer that moved later in his life to Hollywood and composed film music. John Williams was inspired by him for his compositions such as Star Wars. To perform the finale of his piano quintet, I have the pleasure of calling to the stage Anna, who is a Russian-British pianist, Solomon, an Israeli violinist, Kira, who is a 16 years of age Dutch violinist, Maria, a Belarusian viola player, and Gabrielle, a 15 years old French cellist. I'm happy to call these fine musicians to the stage. To perform Brahms' Capriccio, Opus 116, number 3, I have the pleasure of calling to the stage Ekaterina, who is a Portuguese Moldavian pianist. Ekaterina, please. These things may happen. Let's applaud Ekaterina. The third movement of the Poulenc clarinet sonata will be performed by Yassine, who is a 19 years of age clarinet player from Belgium, and Alisa, who is a German-Japanese pianist. Yassine and Alisa, the stage is yours. for a piano quartet. The Rondo of Beethoven's Piano Quartet, Opus 16, will be performed by Tarik, a 15 years of age Turkish pianist, Miguel, Spanish violinist, Amelie, our 16 years of age German viola player, and Hai Ching, our 16 years of age Chinese cellist. Tarik, Miguel, Amelie, and Hai Ching, the stage is yours.
Thank you.
I have the pleasure to call to the stage Maxime, our 16 years of age Italian-Belgian pianist. He will perform the first movement of Prokofiev's first piano concerto, the orchestra part to be performed by our accompanist, Philippe Ivanov. Maxime and Philippe, please. A special piece is to come on stage next, part of our discoveries. The fourth movement of Cohen's trio for harp, cello, and clarinet will be performed by Benjamin, our harp player that arrives from the United States, Sebastian, cellist, who is German, and Jose, who is a Portuguese clarinetist. Let us welcome these three musicians to the stage. Time for a movement from a piano quintet. The finale of Goldmark's piano quintet will be played for you tonight by Steven, our 16 years of age Belgian pianist, by violinist Emile, our young faculty member, Antigone, our 18 years old Belgian violinist, Kat, Belgian viola player, and Gabrielle, 15 years old French cellist. I'm happy to call these five musicians to the stage.
Thank you.
Bloch composed his suite for viola and piano in 1919. To perform the second movement of this suite, I have the pleasure of calling to the stage Xavi, our Spanish violist, together with our accompanist Philippe Ivanov. Xavi and Philippe, please join us on stage.
Thank you.
before the quintet. Ekaterina is back with the Brahms Opus 116, number 3. Let's welcome her. Quintet is in the program tonight. The first movement of the Dandee Quintet will be performed by Tomer, who is 20 years of age and arrives from Israel, by three Spanish musicians, Miguel and Jan, violinist, and Xavi, viola player, and by Haiqing, our 16 years of age Chinese cellist. Let us welcome these five musicians to the stage.
Thank you.
The Rondino on a theme by Beethoven will be performed by 11-year-old Belgian violinist Sophie, accompanied by our official accompanist Ivan. Sophie and Ivan, please join us on stage.
Thank you.
trio is to come on stage next. The jig from Martin's Irish Melodies will be performed by Alisa, our German-Japanese pianist, by Christina, our 20-year-old Bulgarian violinist, and by the cellist Liav, our alumni from Israel and Belgium. Alisa, Christina, and Liav, the stage is all yours.
Thank you.
Before calling to the stage our last ensemble for tonight, I would like, in the name of Leonid, myself, and all our young talents and artists, to thank once more the TVCOM crew for this wonderful collaboration. And thank you, dear public, dear Musica Mundi family, for sharing this evening with us and for your continuous encouragement of this exceptional youth. And of course, do not forget, in less than a week, our next series of live streaming concerts will be presented again from this Bach Concert Hall of the Musica Mundi School. Next Saturday, July 31st at 8 p.m., and our special gala concert on Sunday, August 1st, a concert that will commence at 7 p.m. Belgium time. And now, to conclude tonight's program, I have the pleasure of calling to the stage a string octet. The first movement of Mendelssohn's string octet will be performed by violinists Solomon, Christina, Elisabetta, and Kira, by viola players Xavi and Elias, and by cellists Thais and Liav. All is left for me to do is to wish you a very good night in the name of Leonid and all our special edition participants. Let us welcome on stage the string octet members.
Thank you. Thank you.